earlier, we did move over here to Fairfax and Rosewood, where the cleanup is beginning. Just take a look. You're seeing some of the people that are volunteering from the nearby neighborhood. These are people that came by walking up with their brooms, walking up with their pails, just asking business owners how can they help with the cleanup. And you're seeing here, we're at the Goose Salon, where they are trying to pick up the pieces of a shattered window and help this salon owner. Now this morning, neighbors here, they woke up to the businesses that have been looted and vandalized, some of them even burned. The National Guard we saw out here earlier, they were out here patrolling the streets to keep the peace as the cleanup is getting underway. LA City Mayor Eric Garcetti requested the manpower following the unrest. Initially, protesters led a peaceful march through the streets to protest the death of George Floyd. But as the protest ended, some turned to looting and vandalizing the businesses that were not part of that. Several shops had their windows broken, including the hair salon that we mentioned that was set to reopen here shortly. Of course, it's been closed with the COVID. Items were also taken, we're told, and at a pizza place in Melrose, an employee told us that they were able to evacuate employees and board up their businesses as they watched another nearby business burn. But we're here with the salon owner of Goo. Molly, you were telling us you came this morning and you found your business like this,
totally in shambles, you know, all of the windows being blown out and just all of my stuff being thrown everywhere. But hard enough to see that and watch it on the news. What has helped me is the community, and you can see around here, people were here before I was here, in here sweeping and cleaning and helping me. And if you would have seen this just an hour ago, you wouldn't have believed it. So I just definitely want to thank the Fairfax community for having my back 100%. I'm here for you too. So hopefully we can get through this, and we're gonna open even stronger, I'm hoping. So my prayers and love to everyone that have been affected by this. And, you know, we'll see how everything turns out in the future, so.
You've been closed for ever since the coronavirus pandemic and the stay-at-home order started.
Yesterday was actually the announcement of salons being able to reopen, so we were getting everything ready for the grand reopening. Clients were ready and excited, you know, it's like it was a super happy moment. And then to watch, you know, just go downhill. Even the protest was so peaceful and happy in the beginning, so for it to take that turn and end this way is super unfortunate. But again, the community is super powerful around here, and everyone's coming together, so that's what's going to pull it through and back to where we left off even before COVID. So.
And I should mention, your business has been here since 1999, a long-term business, someone known in this community, known to these shops. Now, I do want to point out, just to turn around, thank you so much, Molly, for talking with us. If we can, just take a look down the street here, and you just see how many people are out here helping their community pick up the pieces by sweeping up, bringing out boards. People are out here just wanting to support their local businesses, many of them the smaller shops that are owned down here, and they just want to figure out a way that they can help their businesses and these business owners start to rebuild their businesses.